Om Sri Sai Ram. Prasanthi Sandesh. That year, on a day, it so happened that the Prasanthi Nilayam appeared to be very, very busy. Few of the students are found running here and there. We also found some security officers around. What's all about this? Curious I am, I made some inquiry. I have come to know that a member from the royal family, maybe of the rank of a queen from Greece, arrived here to have darshan of Bhagavan. She stayed there and we were all watching. And towards the end of the bhajan, she came out of the interview room wiping out tears on her cheeks. Well, are they tears of joy or tears or what? Well, I wanted to know. On inquiry, I came to know that the royal family was given interview by Bhagavan. After having had a long chat, the lady requested private audience with Swami. In other words, she wanted to talk to Swami privately. Therefore, other family members left and she and Swami only were there. Evidently, she wanted to share with Swami, which she doesn't want the family members to come to know. See that Bhagavan is the dearest friend. Bhagavan is the father. Bhagavan is the mother. Bhagavan is totally divine. With who else can we confide other than Bhagavan? Well, after some time she came out, and later I learned that she was crying because her security people informed her earlier that there was no accommodation in Prasanthi Nilayam and there was no airport and it is not possible to reach Prasanthi Nilayam, and therefore the best thing is to return immediately after interview back to Bangalore. In fact, the lady wanted to stay here for 1 or 2 days more. Because of the wrong information given, she could not stay here. For security reasons, she had to oblige them and return. This is an eye-opener to many, that the Swami is closest of all. And that Swami draws people far and near who want to spend time with him more and more. This is with the royal family from Greece. Then I would like to share with you another very important event. One year, maybe close to Christmas or so, some people were talking and I just wanted to know what they were speaking about. It seems that a bishop from France came on a visit to Prasanthi Nilayam and that he would be staying there for a week. And surprisingly enough, the bishop joined Swami at the dinner table. He had breakfast with Swami, lunch with Swami, snack with Swami, and dinner with Swami. And after bhajan morning, after bhajan in the evening, Swami used to take Bishop in his car and go for a ride. It all seems to be Bishop season. Everybody were talking about him. How is that Swami gave him such an importance? Why? But I had no chance to see him. But I really wanted to see him. What can I do? Because he sits in the front, very close to the door leading to the bhajan hall in the front. Well, how can I see him? Somehow it so happened that it was Sunday. Swami called some group for an interview and closed the door, and I could venture to walk from behind to the front, only with a view to see the bishop. I could see him. A man of golden complexion, with white beard and a bald head, wearing a black gown, black dress. By his side, I saw his disciple, who was quite tall, who also was in blacks. He was also a very handsome man, with pointed nose. I thought that he would make a very good role if he were to play the role of Jesus Christ. I could see both of them. Unexpectedly, Swami opened the door and came out. "Anil Kumar, why are you here?" What am I to tell him? Because I walked all the distance from behind to the front only to see the bishop. Now Swami asked me, "Why are you here?" Well, I was very honest enough and told Swami, "I wanted to see bishop." Immediately Swami remarked, "When bishop came to Swami, you have come to see the bishop. That is your situation." Everybody in the veranda laughed. And then after some time, Swami granted interview to bishop and his disciple and called two ladies. They also hailed from royal family from Belgium, the mother and the daughter. So four of them were called for an interview. They went in. Immediately after a couple of seconds, Swami opened the door and asked me to get into the interview room. I went in. Then Swami said in Telugu, "You wanted to see the bishop? You can see him. Now see him thoroughly, completely, to your satisfaction." I smiled, thanked Swami. When all of us were seated, Swami started speaking. "Bishop of France wanted to travel across this country, India, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, visiting all interesting places. But having come to Prasanthi Nilayam, having met Swami, he decided not to go anywhere. He decided to spend all his time in Prasanthi Nilayam until the last day. Therefore, I am giving him all that he deserves for his prayerfulness and for his devotion. Moreover, today happens to be his birthday. So I wanted to bless him. And hence, I gave him interview. Now all my doubts are cleared, and the matter was clearly known to me. Please believe me," Swami started speaking on the Holy Bible to the bishop from France. "I was a student of a Christian college and also on the faculty with acquaintance of the Holy Scripture Bible for over 30 years. That's fine. I heard many sermons from the pulpit. I heard many of Christian missionaries talking to us. But to my utter astonishment, I saw Bhagavan speaking on the Holy Bible, mentioning several of the anecdotes there, giving a new interpretation, a new meaning, a unique explanation. Then it was left to the bishop, who was simply nodding his head, exclaiming, Oh, Swami, is that so? Oh, Swami. He was thrilled, excited, ecstatic to come to know these, the secrets and the gems from the Holy Scripture Bible. And Swami was very happy with the entire group, introduced them to me, and he introduced me to them. I was fortunate enough to have translated his divine discourse in the interview room. And at the end of the interview, Swami materialized a very small cup, golden cup, with a gold spoon. And that gold cup is full of amrit or ambrosia or elixir, full to the brim. And Swami wanted me to hold that cup. I was holding it on my hand. And Swami, with that gold spoon materialized, asked every one of them, assembled in the interview room, "Open your mouth." They opened. And then he gives them one spoon of amrit. He pours one spoon of amrit to everyone, one each. So all of them had amrit, two here from France and two from Belgium. They had one spoon each of amrit. They were very, very happy. Then I was doubtful. "Swami, would you give me or not?" Immediately looked at me and said, "Jealousy? No, I'll give you two. Open your mouth." Then he gave me one. He poured out one spoon of amrit into my mouth. But still, some more amrit is left in that small gold cup. Well, what will happen to this remaining part of amrit? I was just questioning myself. Swami immediately turned around and said, "Anil Kumar, you speak a lot. I'll give you the remaining portion of amrit also. Open your mouth." He poured out the entire lot to me. I was very, very happy. But one thing is, because I was holding the cup, some drops fell on my palm, and I was feeling very sticky, as if something like a gum. Well, blessing everybody, sending everyone, after giving Vibhuti Prasadam, Swami looked deep into my eyes and said, "About 50 years ago, I materialized Amrutam. Only today, I materialized for this bishop. Now I tell you, don't tell anybody. Do you understand? Now you go," said Swami. I came out of the interview room. Well, finding out my fingers stretched, because they were, as I said, it was sticky, I had stretched my fingers. And several people could come to know something went on inside the interview room. I know most of the Savadal members because I have been in the organization for the last 50 years. At the gate, several members came to me and said, "Sir, what happened inside?" Swami said, "Don't tell. What am I to do? But one thing is this. My palm was smelling like a scent. Anything like a Paris champagne. Very good smell, like any other scent. Aromatic, fragrant. So what I did was, without answering them, I kept my palm very close to the nose of each one of them. They could smell. Appa, they are very, very happy. Then I could answer myself this way. Swami said, don't tell. But he did not tell me, don't smell. Don't smell, he did not tell me. He only told me, don't tell. So I did not tell anybody and allowed everybody to smell. Then came home, watching me, my wife saw the fingers stretched. And she asked me, what happened to your fingers? Why are you doing like that? I said, everything is sticky and Amrita Swami materialized. Therefore, I must wash my hands now. She said, don't do it now, just wait. She brought a plate and wanted me to wash my hands there. Friends, believe me, the fragrance and the smell remained for a fortnight. For a fortnight, 15 days. Most surprisingly, this I wanted to share with you to let you know the grace of Bhagavan. Sai Ram, we'll meet later.